And welcome to This Side of the Fence. My name is J.C. Wilkinson. We are here at The Pound. This is my regular show. And I have a very, very special guest who is taking major leaps and bounds in her career, and I'm really excited for her. This is Ms. Jamie Labrador has joined us today. And we have Jamie on stage right now, and she's going to share an original song with us. And this is called Can't Breathe. Whenever you're ready.
Just saw you, you were laughing, and you came to me and said I should talk to you more often. You said you miss me and we should catch up. I thought I had forever and a day. Wrong, because the way that you fell hard, and now I'm here standing looking down at you. You're not looking back at me. Why do you have to leave? Use this time to say the words I never said, but I can't breathe, I can't breathe, no. And I can't help but wonder how this could fate. 'Cause I never imagined by the time I came back it would be too late. Sometimes it's hard to deal with the pain we've come to face. Up, I know you rose up with grace, but I'm still here standing looking down at you. You're not looking back at me. Why do you have to leave? And I should use this time to say the words I never. But I can't breathe, I can't breathe. Well, I hope you're doing fine wherever you are, and I know I'll see that pretty face again. And when I miss you, I just look up at the stars. I know this isn't the end. This isn't the end. But I'm still here standing looking down at you. You're not looking back at me. Why do you have to leave? Why'd you have to leave? Why do you have to leave? And I should use this time to say the words I never said, but I'm still here looking down at you. You're not looking back at me. I knew I had to set you free, yeah. And I should should use this time to say the words I never said. But I can't breathe, can't breathe, can't breathe. I can't breathe.
All right, that was Jamie Labrador. And she was singing her original song, Can't Breathe. We're going to give Jamie a second to come back and join us here at the desk. I'm JC Wilkinson. You are listening to This Side of the Fence. We are here at the Pound. A lot of things have happened in Jamie's life over the last few days. And we're actually going to talk about a few of them. And as I said at the beginning of the show, I'm really, really excited for her because this is something Jamie and I have been working on for a couple of years now. Hello, Ms. Jamie Labrador. How are you?
Hello, I'm good.
Okay. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Really, really excited for you to be here. Now, first thing I'd like to chat about, that song, Can't Breathe. Give us a little background on like where the song came from. And
okay. Well, I wrote this song kind of near the beginning of the year, I think around in February or March.
Okay.
And it was actually like, I feel like it was like a week after the funeral of one of my childhood friends.
Okay.
And it was the, I think the second song that I've ever written. I haven't been writing music for too long. But I don't know, I was just really looking for kind of an outlet of feelings and my emotions and stuff like that, because that's a crazy thing to deal with.
Sure.
And I don't know, I was just sitting at home one day and I started playing around on the guitar and that song kind of came to me instantly.
Awesome. Well, it's an amazing song. I mean, I've heard it quite a few times, and it's very powerful. And just the idea of, I mean, being a musician myself, taking your passion and your gift and just applying it to help you get through your own personal stuff. Because, I mean, you know, a lot of people say, like, oh, that song that you wrote, it was so cool and it helped me get through this troubling times. But for us to be able to do it for ourselves is, like, is really huge. And the fact that you actually just turned 16 is, I think, is a really, really cool, huge step for yourself as a musician and an artist, because that's something you'll be able to carry with you as you continue on in your career. So big kudos to you for that.
You.
Now, you just did your first solo show.
Yes. We did it at the Lakehead Unitarian on Algoma. Yeah. And it was a little nerve-wracking because I had never done a show that was just mine before, where I had people opening for me. Like,
yeah.
I'm so used to it being the opposite, or just sharing the stage with a bunch of people.
Right.
And that's, it was weird because I haven't been like super nervous for a show in a really long time. But
right.
Now that my face was on the poster and it was like Jamie Labrador, I was like, this is crazy. So
yeah.
It was really fun. I had a lot of fun and I feel like a lot of people enjoyed it. So.
Yeah, they did. And I actually got to open for you. So that was actually really cool. Nick Kahn, myself, we played a few songs and then sort of got everybody warmed up. And then you just I mean, like literally, you just took over. And that's what I was hoping would happen. So, yeah, we were very excited for you. I think we had about 40, 45 people came. We managed to raise some money for your demo CD.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yes.
That was very nice.
Raised. Over $1,400, I think.
Yeah. So
that one day.
That was really cool. So that definitely puts you well on your way. And we had some, I think there was a penny auction, some door prizes, and a few other things were happening as well. Now, being involved in your music career and helping you and sort of organizing events and stuff, this was actually the first time that your family and the community members all kind of stepped up at the beginning of this planning session and said, okay, we're going to help. Let's go.
Yeah.
And it was actually very, very cool. I mean, we have even assistance from like Red Lake all the way down. And your auntie, Vicky, she helped out as well. And your cousin Ed and your cousin Christopher. And holy cow, it's like, yeah, quite a few people. And community members, even my landlady stepped up and she invited her sister and they donated a few prizes and stuff. Now, doing your own first show, I know you get on the stage and especially like when you're playing with other musicians or whatever and you're doing your thing. And it's like you have your little time slot and then you're done. Now, knowing that, when you're done, like the show's over, is that like a totally different perspective?
Kind of. Usually, I guess usually I'm not super nervous for a show like that because it's like, okay, well, if I go at the beginning and I'm really good, then I kind of, you know, set a little bar for the rest of the show. If I'm not too great, then people forget about it by the end. Or if, like, at the end, okay, it's over. Right. It's, like, no big deal. But that the beginning set and the second set were just me. It was, like, it was really nerve-wracking, but I think I got through it pretty well.
Yeah, I think you did excellent. I was actually to hear everything except for your encore song because I had to leave actually early. But you are going to do another song for us shortly. I believe this one's called Where Were You? Mm-hmm. And this is one of my personal favorites. And I've told you this like 100 times and I'll try to tell you like 100 more. There's something about this song that really speaks to me on all kinds of different levels, which is it's just kind of neat because, I mean, that's how I really enjoy music. But you haven't, like you said before, you haven't been writing songs for that long, but the fact that the songs that you write have that depth and that quality, I would say if somebody who's like a little bit older than you, have a little more life experience than you do, but it comes from a really cool place. So like, I'm really excited for you on what you're going to be able to do in the future. Now give us a little bit of background on Where Were You? Like, where did that come from?
Okay. Well, sometimes I write things, but I don't really know what to classify them as. Sometimes I'm just kind of writing on paper. Sometimes it's in the notes on my phone. Right. And I'm just kind of, again, looking for that outlet of feelings and stuff like that. And I guess it was kind of like a poem, but it was kind of more like a story. It wasn't really, okay. I couldn't really classify it as anything, but I really liked some of the lyric or the words in it. And I was like, well, I'm not really going to do anything with this as just a piece of writing.
Okay.
So I put some of the lyrics into a song from a chord progression that I was working on a little bit earlier. And then that song kind of happened.
Just kind of happened, eh? That's cool when it kind of happens. I mean, this is a good thing. And like I said, it is one of my favorite songs. I think what we're going to do now is we're going to take a short break and we're going to have you get back up on stage and get ready. And then when we come back, we're going to listen to Where Were You?
Awesome.
All right.
And I saw an infinity of stars. Now I look into the same eyes and all I see is the dark. Oh, the dark. Where were you when I was stumbling through my life and I didn't know where to go? This time that's me to think, was I just imagining? Were we slowly dying? Where were you? pretend I was untrue. When all I'll ever be is faithful and loyal to you. Oh, our love was like a supernova. Burned so bright and then it was over. Just imagining, were we slowly dying? Where were you when everything we had turned to darkness, and the promises we kept were forgotten? All those lonely nights when I had nothing to lose. Just answer me this, answer me this. Where were you? Where were you when I was stumbling through my life? And I didn't know where to go. This time left me to think, was I just imagining? Were we slowly dying? Where were you?
All right, very cool. That was Jamie Labrador. And she was singing, Where Were You? It's an original song of hers. We're going to leave Jamie up on stage, and we're going to chat with her from there because she's going to do another song with us before we end the show today. Yes. Oh, I just really like that song. It's like very cool. Okay, working as a youth mentor, 4 a.m. It's 4 a.m. Thunder Bay Association. I am the director. And Jamie's done some work with us. And we did, it was, I can't remember what break it was. I think it was it Easter break? When we did the show with the kids at Victoriaville Mall.
I think it was March break.
March break, yeah. Yeah, March break last year. Actually, March break this year. And we kind of dropped Jamie and Cassie to Houston to the deep end and said, okay, you're going to lead these 35 children that are sitting on the floor staring at you with great big eyes. And you handled it really well. I mean, what was that experience like to be able to just sort of like dropped in the middle of it and all the kids were like, okay, what are we doing?
It was fun. I really like working with kids and just entertaining them and having them engaged and everything. It was really nice. And I just really like working with kids. So it was really fun for me.
Okay. Now, I don't know if you realize it or not, but ever since the first time I started working with you, we started doing shows like at Victoriaville Mall and a few other places, all the kids love you. Like they sit there, their eyes get really big and they just go like, oh my God, listen to her, listen to her. And they get all excited. You probably have, I would say off the top of my head, from what I remember, in the last 2 years, at least 40 kids that are fans, like big fans of yours. Because every time we go play somewhere, they go, where is she? Where is she? Because I'm setting up the equipment and they want to know where you are. That is actually a really cool thing. And that has a lot to do with your personality and just the type of person that you are. Now, we are planning to go to Eagle Lake. And Eagle Lake First Nation. It's just outside of Dryden. And we're going to do some work with them. And we're actually going to do a concert there as well. Mm-hmm. Now, What are you thinking as far as youth mentoring goes? I mean, would you like to work with the youth there and like maybe do a workshop or something? Or
well, I definitely want to do something with people my age and younger, even a little older maybe. if you would have asked me this question like a couple years ago, I'd been like, no, that is my dad's reserve. I know people there. They know me. But no, I'm a little bit more fine with talking to people that I know,
right,
and performing. I just really want to get people involved that are interested in music, because I know at first it wasn't easy for me.
Right.
And I don't know. I just think that if somebody is really serious about music and they live on the reservation, there's not much you can do with it, even if you have like incredible talent. So I really want to find some people that are really interested in it and just work with them. And I think that would be really fun.
Okay. That sounds really cool. Now, something just popped into my head, as it does often. What do you think about the idea of, and this is probably going to happen like within the next couple of years, but when you like get established and sort of firmly on your road and everything is running for you the way you want to, finding a few people at different communities and just kind of doing like a First Nations tour. What do you think about that idea? Would that be cool?
I really, really like that idea.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to make a little note to self here. First Nations tour featuring Jamie Labrador and...
A couple years ago when we went to Pelican Falls?
Yeah, Pelican Falls, right?
Pelican Falls. I noticed that a lot of people at that high school were really interested in, you know, kids their age being so actively involved in music. And they were just really interested. And I kind of felt a little bad that we couldn't do too much over there far as youth mentoring goes.
Yeah.
But it was just a really cool experience, and I want to do more stuff like that.
Okay, awesome. We'll definitely put that into the works. So actually what we're going to do now is, you are going to do one of the songs that really got Shelley Buffett's attention. She's actually been on the show a couple of times. She's the CEO of Gel Music Group Canada, and, Jamie's being signed to the artist, development department, and we're going to get her CD ready and everything. And then, Jamie will be an officially signed artist, which is like really, really exciting. So this particular song is the one that I sent a bunch of demos to Shelley, and Shelley responded to this one, and I'm pretty sure it was 15 seconds. she hadn't even finished listening to the whole thing. She clicked and she said, we have to record this. And I was like, okay. So we're going to let Jamie take it away with Wasted Time.
I was head over heels when I met you, but you didn't know the kind of girl you turned me into. You acted like everything is fine when in your mind you wanted to walk away, but you didn't choose to say anything. It's not the right time, maybe another day. You know it doesn't really matter anyway. But you could've told me, you could've told me, you could've told me that I was wasting, wasting, wasting my time on you. I was wasting, wasting, I was wasting my time on you. Oh, oh, all this wasted time on. Looked into my eyes, I was under your spell. You know you said the word forever. Does that ring a bell? Be told all my friends what she should have told me. I could have heard it for myself, but instead you made me feel like there was still something there and that you still cared about me, baby. Why couldn't I tell that I was wasting, wasting, wasting my time on you? I was wasting, wasting, I was wasting. time on you. All this wasted time on you. How didn't I know? Voice like you come and go. But I have grown into someone you'll never know. You took my heart and tore it in two. Now all I want back is all my wasted time on you. All this wasted time. All this wasted time. Wasting my time on you. I was wasting my time on you. Oh, oh.
Very nice. It was Jamie Labrador with Wasted Time, her original song. You are listening to This Side of the Fence. We are here at The Pound. My name is JC Wilkinson. We're just about to wrap up this show. So a special shout out and thank you to Jamie for coming and sharing her music with us. We're really happy to have you, and you are more than welcome back anytime. So
thank you.
No problem. Maybe we'll work on bringing a band with you next time. See what we can do.
Space is a little tight up here, but
yeah, I know. Well, at least one or two more people. Yeah. So there are many, many things that are going to happen in your future, and it's really, really cool that the community and Eagle Lake First Nation community and other communities are starting to discover what I discovered when I first heard you sing when you were like 12 years old. And you just had this, I just had this sense that there's this big booming voice just raring to get out. And I've actually been able to discover that over the last couple of years. And just to watch you grow and watch you explore new things and develop as into a young lady and to a rising star. I think that's really, really cool. And it's a really cool just to be part of your journey. So I say miigwech for that. I think we're running out of time here. So, big shout out to the college for letting us have this show. Big shout out to the crew in the control room who, without them, I don't think this could actually happen because Jamie and I would just talk to ourselves and you guys wouldn't be able to hear a thing we say. So, my name is JC Wilkinson. It's an honor and a privilege to be able to do this web radio show. And again, special shout out. Thank you, Jamie, for coming. And that'll be it for this episode, and we are out.
I'ma leave the light on. Something in my closet's gonna get me, but I ain't tough enough to make it all go away. Out and then they'll no longer have such a big hold on me. I remember everyone always telling me, be careful what you say or do.